Evening, folks. This is Best in Slot, and we are back with yet more Ancestors, the Humankind Odyssey. And that's right, I said Odyssey this time instead of Legacy for the very first time ever. I finally found myself some basalt. I've been a little bit busy. I'm going to explain what I've been doing in a moment. What we're doing right now is using the basalt chopper, which is amazing, to sharpen sticks. If you hit a normal stick, not even a stripped stick, 5 times with the basalt chopper, it turns it into a sharpened stick. So it's a really, really handy tool, and we're going to make 2 of them and take them back to the base. Of course, the other thing the basalt chopper does is lets us cut up meat. Now, I believe there's a macarodus somewhere in this area. Is that in there? Nope, that's a warhog. That's okay. We could do with killing a warhog. What I really want to do is kill something. The idea being what we need to do is eat some meat. So, we're going to come back here. No. No. We're going to come back here in a minute. What we're going to do now is grab 2 sharpened sticks. Like an absolute baller. I'm going to grab those and we're going to go murder some warhogs. Look at our ape go. Now, I've learned quite a lot since the last video, mainly in terms of evolving. This is something I kind of started to gather across the last couple hours or so. I think this is a mistake a lot of people make, myself included, and that is that they don't evolve often enough. Evolving in this game is super important to lock down those genetic mutations. You should really be evolving every 2 generations in order to max out those mutations. Maybe not straight away, because if you do it at the start of the game, you'll be a little bit weak, you'll move base, you'll get attacked by Stalker Cat. But once you're past a certain point, you can really start evolving a lot more. And I've been doing it a lot and locking in loads of mutations, which you'll see in a moment. Come here, buddy. Come on. Alright, I was hoping for a 1-hit kill. This should kill him. There we go. Booga booga! Nice and easy. Lovely stuff. Who are we playing as, by the way? We're playing as Liu. So, one thing Louie needs to get better at is eating meat. We're not very omnivorous so far. We've started to go in that direction, but we haven't quite made it. So the idea is to get a little bit better at eating meat, and that the only way to do that is by killing things and farming some meat. Plus, I want to kill some things for the sake of... Oh. Nay, there we go. I want to kill some things simply for the sake of, you know, get their feet, and just so we feel like a badass murderous ape, basically. So we're just going to make ourselves another chopper. Because I want to bring a couple of these back to the base with me. Is that the chopper on the ground? Yes, it is. I put those in the wrong hand. Fantastic. Let's grab that. Let's grab that. And remember, the other plan for today is to go and make a new base. We're going to move. Oh, hello, Cheeky. Screw you. I will beat you with my chopper. Now, the good thing about the chopper, you can see I've actually still got both of my hands, which is pretty cool. Come on, buddy. Come on. Yeah, you better run, egg. You better run. Anyways, on we go. We're just going to go cut up that warhog, eat some delicious meat, and then the plan is to move our base back over to the woodlands for the very first time. We are going to be doing an evolve in a minute, though, which will mean, of course, that we will move base again. Where the hell is that? There it is. Right, let's leave this basalt somewhere. I will remember it. I want to take both of those back home with us. Nope, I need one of them. What am I doing? Let's grab one of those. Let's go cut this bad boy up. Where have you gone, beautiful? There you are. Let us begin the butchering. Ooga booga, ooga booga. I can hear the macarodus again. Hello? Oh, it's his friend. Okay, come on then. Come here. Come on. Bam. Stupid warhog. Right, let's put that back in the pile. Let's go get some meat. And again, we're going to chow down. It's going to make us sick. We're getting a little bit better at it, but the hope is eventually our ape will be able to eat tons of meat, raw meat, and totally benefit from it. Because we know we're heading to the woodland, for example, even, which has less trees and less plants and stuff like that. So we need to get good at chowing down on meat. And at the moment, we kind of suck at it. But we'll get there. I'm just going to grab my chopper. Where's my chopper? It's over here. That warhog's about to start me, and I want to be ready for it. Also, I hear something else. Just because I killed your buddy. Oh, God. Whoops. Made a mistake. Let's grab that chopper again. Let's grab both. Where's he gone? Has he run away? What a little coward! Picks a bloody fire and then does one. I've got broken bones and I'm sick from chowing down on meat, but I don't care, we must continue. Ape love meat. Ape love meat lots. Okay. The warthog is back. We grab our chopper and I'm gonna bash it in the face. That's not a chopper. There we go, come on. Just in time. Hep, bump. I don't know how much it takes for a kill, but I imagine it's quite a lot. Eat. I'm num 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 num. And look, he's not getting sick as much. That will get... And as soon as I say that, he instantly falls ill. He gets a bit of food poison. That's okay. Like I said, this is just something we're going to get better and better at over time. And that is very much the goal. Okay, we're nearly home. What we're going to do is we're going to drop the basalt choppers. Now, we're about to evolve, but we always end up back in this base over and over again. I've ended up back here 5-6 times now. So I think we can leave the choppers here and safely come back to them down the line. That's the idea anyway. Hi gang, how are we all doing? Everyone having fun? Everyone's having a grand time. So we're just going to leave these somewhere we recognise, because I want to be able to pick these up, just because I never find basalt anywhere. It's important to me. And we're going to hop over to a bed. I want to show you what I've been up to. My little monkeys. So, evolution. Ah, did we finally get it? That's the one I've been looking for. Improves how we walk on two legs. Now, we actually probably don't have the neural energy to grab this right now. We don't want to grab this right now. You can see if we look around, all of these little orange ones with the bright lights, those are ones that we have the genetic mutation active. Now, the only way to grab those permanently is to evolve. So we've got that one there, we've got one up here as well, which means we can craft items better. We've got one, we've got two, three over here, four over here actually. We've got this one, which means we can remember more things. We've got this one, remember more things. We get more food from energy from food, and we reduce our food poisoning. So we've got loads of genetic mutations, which are gonna, six, which I believe is the max, genetic mutations are gonna become active with one generational shift. It's a big deal to lock in these mutations when you can. See, I don't have any reinforcements. My evolution is barely going to jump forward. We really didn't do much new since the last time. I believe I did... Tell you what, let's just do it and we'll find out. So we did Basalt Chopper as a tool twice. And we did... use all rock items as tools. Very cool. I'm a leading tool user, apparently. Well, usually a tool, so I'm meant to be a tool user. Crafted a Basalt Chopper 5 times. Acted on a carcass of any sort with the right tool at least twice. That should be most of them, yep. You see, we're way ahead of science right now, so jumping forward isn't really a big deal. We should get some bonuses for my generational births. Now, apparently the game ends at about 2 million years, which is actually another reason you want to be evolving a lot. You want to lock in those mutations before you hit that 2 million year mark. You want to unlock everything in the game, right? You want your apes to be as strong as they can. If you keep having really good evolutions every single time, like our first one was, that insane one, we jumped forward like 2 million years or something. If you do that every single time, you'll hit the end of the game and not have unlocked anything. You need to keep shifting those evolutions forward and lock in those mutations while you get the chance. I'm learning things. Right, folks, we've evolved many, many, many times. Many genetic mutations locked in. At the moment, we don't really have any I'd say super excited about. I want this one over here. That one, yes, the ability of moving on two legs can still grow up. I really want to focus on that aspect of the game, that motricity aspect. But as you can see, we're looking pretty damn good. We've got loads of reinforcements ready to go. There's a lot of these that still haven't been fulfilled. We can do these quite easily. We need to go do some fighting. We need to scan some more stuff. You know, we need to build more things. We can definitely do this kind of thing as well. We need to sleep more, apparently, which I think is true for real life as well. But no more, not now. I'm tired of the jungle. We've been here too long. It's time for our apes to move on to their new life. Now, just before we do that, I am going to do one other thing. We're going to grab ourselves some babas. Okay, we're going to end the expedition. Piggyback. Grab some babas. And just because we don't know what's about to happen, I don't know what's going to occur on this journey, who we're going to find, what's going to happen, who's going to die. We are going quite a long way. what we're going to do is analyse our dead clan members. I just want to build up this neuronal energy nice and fast. Just before we head off. Just in case. You never know. Got to be prepared, folks. Got to be prepared. So we're looking for our dead clan members. Our lovely dead people. And it sounds a little bit morbid, but it's educational, right? We're walking around the babies and we're showing them. This is what happens when you die. It's like the boogeyman equivalent, but with apes and skeletons. I'm sure there's a lesson there somewhere. I am going to call that done. We can analyse more sounds if possible, but what we also want to do is maybe... I was going to give them all sticks, but to be honest, we're probably going to be doing intimidation rather than fighting. What I am going to do is give the babies to the adults. Where are my babies? There's more babies. Give all the babies to the adults. Oh! Come on, baby! Eh? Nope. I can't get to the baby. It's in the way. Everyone's blocking my babies. There we go. Piggyback. There we go. Right, everyone has children. We are going to swap to an adult male and we are going to head over into a brand new world. So I'm going to gather the clan people together. I'm going to top this rock like so. It's a tree, but whatever. Clan, hear my cry. And watch them all stand up. Look over at me, their fearless leader. Come on, boys, girls. I think that works. We're all gonna grab a drink first. You gotta be prepared for these journeys, folks. It's a long, long way we're about to go. Let's go. I'm going to assume they're following me. I'm hoping they're following me. There we go, look at that, beautiful! The squad, oh, the squad is on the way once more. Now, we are heading past the lake. Way over into the distance. So that is the lake swamp, so we're going to head in that direction first of all, and then we're going to go past that, we're going to go back to the woodland where we went in the last video, but this time we're taking the gang with us. Look at them all, 2 feet. My two-legged walking is a lot better. It's not there yet. She'll drop down in just a couple of seconds, probably. There she goes. But it has improved. Okay. Hello? Okay. You okay, buddy? You're probably fine. I'm sure you're fine. Don't worry about it. I'm not worried about it. He'll be bleeding slightly, but that's... It's fine. Technically, as long as the 4 babies survive, it doesn't actually matter at this point in time. I think. You need 4 babies and an adult. 6 babies, I should say. As long as the 6 babies and an adult make it, you are basically set and good to go. You don't really need anything more than that to establish a new base, because you just skip forward a generation, mate, and do it again. Hello, buddy. Booga booga! Trying to intimidate, but it's not working. There we go. Ooh. And again, if we can't. Nope. Ladies and gentlemen, we've finally reached the woodland. I'm a little bit worse for wear, admittedly. We've struggled a little bit with food on the journey across here, and now we're in a fairly... Oh, hello. We're in a fairly dead part of the woodland, to say the least. I'm also really struggling to intimidate for some reason. I don't really know what's going on, but... Booga booga. You, my friend, are not looking good. She's bleeding badly. She's probably about to die, unfortunately. But we must press on. Because if we hang around too long looking after individual members, we end up in trouble anyway. Does that make sense? Hello, cave system. What we need is some food. That's what we need. We need noms. Mushrooms. Mushrooms will do. Food is food at this point in time. We may all get food poisoning. That's okay. Come on, gang. Everyone, mushroom up. At least if we eat the mushrooms, we'll get better eating mushrooms, right? That tends to be how it works. No one else seems that interested in eating mushrooms. Okay, never mind. We'll push on. I'll find you guys something better to eat. Ah, this bloody leadership role has been thrust upon me. But, okay. I guess. Maybe this place right here, maybe this little spot right here is going to be our new home. Let's go check it out. All I need is a nice little water source, and just somewhere that doesn't feel like I'll get molested by cats every 5 bloody seconds. Over there's that one that we really liked, but it was very out in the open. Where are we now? Let's find out. Looking for the words oasis or secluded or hidden or anything like that. It's hillock oasis. This could be the spot. Oasises tend to be, oases I think is the word, tend to be pretty safe. Is this going to be our new home? At least temporarily. We're going to evolve a lot, it's going to move us around, but I think this looks alright to me. It's a little bit on the open side, but not bad. There's water source. It's nothing fancy, right? It's a very low-key home, but I think, given the situation, given everything's a little bit rough right now, and I'd kind of like to get my apes settled ASAP, I think this might be the plan, you know? Oh, but first we need to register it. Or do we? What's going on? That's very... there we go. Right, okay, let's just grab this. Lots to scan as well. Beautiful. Very helpful indeed. All my apes are spooked. Having a terrible time. But we're nearly there, guys. We're nearly there. I tell you what, let's just nip to the left. If we just stand here, it's safe. If you go any further forward, it's terrifying. Stop eating! You need water, you fool! Okay, get some food. Then we're having some water, okay? Stop arguing with me. Look, they're all in bad shape. Water. Drink. You fools. Sip from its delicious nectar. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There should be 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I may have lost 2. I see all the babies though. As long as you've got all the babies, nothing else really matters. What I'd like to do is stop here if possible. To do that, we need to make a bed. And to make a bed, we need cicads, cicandos. So let's just grab these. 1, 2, and 1/3. I'm rocking these loads of new neurons. Absolutely tons of them. Go, 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 look at him run! It's a monster, man. He's got the 2 kids strapped to him. He's carrying a bed around. He's a man of the people. He's a Renaissance man. Gonna put the bed right there. Craft that, hopefully. And settle. There we go. New home established. Finally, the apes are in the woodland. And now we can probably explore this area, see new creatures, and there we go! Sorry. And evolution. It's 5, 6, 7. That's a lot of new neurons. Right, let's pick what we want. What have we got here? We have... less scared of opponent. Ah, this one's cool. Once connected, it'll be possible to ask clan members to mimic the grabbing of an item, then switching hand, or eating if it is food. So, we could go grab like a... Basically, I think if we make a pile of sharpened sticks, and we set our clan members to mimic, and then we pick up a sharpened stick, they should all come up and pick up a sharpened stick. After having grabbed an item, double tap B for the clan members close to you to mimic your grabbing. Very cool. That's going to be useful when we make our... ape death squads, which is, you know, top priority, obviously. Just gonna grab... very slowly grab this one. And we've got neuronal energy for days, it really doesn't matter, but still. A little bit less spooked, good stuff. What else do we have? We have... you can shield for longer time against food poisoning. That's not that exciting, but we'll pick it up anyway. Yeah, there's loads of these going down here. And what's this one? Shield against injuries for a longer time. Again, not that exciting, but we want to get them all, right? The idea is to make the ultimate ape, essentially. Oh, we can get that one as well. Okay, we can eat mushrooms. We can eat eggs. Is there any actually good ones anywhere in this list? Is it all my eating? Am I just eating myself? Yeah, we'll grab that one. Less fear sounds like a plan to me. Come on, buddy. Take your time. There we go. Less scared of predators. We're going to grab these ones as well, I think. Yeah, I thought that might have another one. There'll be like, you can eat even more mushrooms. We can fully metabolize. So once we've done this one, once we've done the egg one, we can eat eggs, we can eat mushrooms with no problems whatsoever. I think it is handy to have the ability to eat all the foods, you know, without any real issues, and that way, you know, you've always got food sources around. I wonder what that one is. No idea. But we need to eat some meat, I know that much. Looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. So we want to lock these in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Generation skip. Oh. So we got a few more genetic modifications kind of active because our babies are becoming adults. Honestly, there's none that are that exciting. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some kids. So you always, the first thing we should really do is mate the kids every single time. So I'm going to do that. And then we're going to pick one of our members and we're going to maybe head out into the wilderness and explore the woodlands just a little bit as well. Because we haven't really been in this area. We don't know what's out there at all. Alright, so we're going to go on our first expedition, solo expedition for now, into the woodland from our brand new base. Unfortunately, two of my apes somehow died in the generational jump. So I am currently down two apes, which means I'm currently down two babies, which means, yeah, that's not good, right? You want as many apes as humanly possible for your death squads, for your, for more mutations and stuff like that. Losing apes is actually kind of a big deal. So what we're doing is we're going off into the woodlands, but we're also going to try to find ourselves. What is that? Is that a new animal? Question mark. I need to hit it with a stick, usually. It's got to be, right? I heard it. What would make sound if not an animal? I'm going to go grab this over here. Little swamp area. Anyways, so the goal is to find, hopefully, another female. That's going to help us fix that little boo-boo we've had, unfortunately. I don't really know how it happened. They just... Oh, why are you all following me? This wasn't meant to be a death squad. Oh, I guess it is now. Oh, look at it! It's a horse! It's actually a group of horses. Look at that! How cool is that? Very cool. If we go on sound, focus, we can discover. There we go, new wildlife discovery, Miocene African horse. Can we ride the horse? Can we rise to the Planet of the Apes up in this kind of area? Let's go find out. We're going to walk towards the horse. I'm not going to kill the horse, but I'm going to approach it. Do they run from us or? Yes, they do. Gang, I love that you're all here with me, but can we go home, please? I don't want you here. I've already lost two of you. If I lose any more of you, I'm in big trouble. So no, go home. All right. What's that? What is it? It's something else. Something else. It's something else. It's something else. It's something else. I'm very excited. What is it? It looks small. Whatever it is. It's hyenas! It's a many hyenas! Oh no! is this too many Oh, okay. Hello. This is fine. I did my dodge. Didn't expect this, to be honest. Stick, please. Come here, you. Ugh, get out of it. Hooga booga. Hooga booga. Um. guys. Interesting area down there. Is that a savannah? Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I know the third area of the game is the savannah. I'm just trying to like build some suspense. The third area of the game is the savannah. That's very, very cool. I did not realize we were this close. I am bleeding to death. Slight problem. Very slight problem. I would like to fix that slight problem. Unfortunately, I believe kapok fiber is much rarer in this kind of area. Go away. Am I being hunted here? Feels like it. Yeah. Go away. Who am I playing as? Moo. Moo does not care for you, Mr. Hyena. Moo is a monster of a man. There's no kapok anywhere. At this point, my elders are hungry, nearly dying, and ignoring all my commands. But we've given a couple of them sharpened sticks. I've got a sharpened stick myself. I'm still bleeding. I can't find a kapok fiber to save my bloody life, which is quite literally what it's for at this point in time. But I see some hyenas, and we're going for it. Monkey Death Squad, assemble! There we go. I want everyone else to come and do the same thing, basically. I'm not sure that's quite going to work out the way I want it to, however. Oh, hello. Oh god. Well, that was mean. I'm sorry, Mr. Horse, I really am. What is that? Let's go find out. Let's go find out what that thing is. And then we're gonna go skip forward to it's a dead. Yeah, hello. Booga booga. Just training my dodge, that's all. Where are my apes? Where are my clan? I'm so alone. This is our food now, buddy boy. Yeah, there we go. Hey, look at that. Get him, get him, get him. Get him! Oh my god, yes! Our ape is a baller! Nice! The clan did so. That's the first time a member of our clan has ever killed anything. That is impressive stuff. And if we want, we can come back and feast on some meaty bits. First, I need to go die in a corner somewhere. What's this? Oh, it's a white one. Is that the white one? Yeah. I need a stick, man. Apes, assist me. Come on. You did it a second ago. I believe in you. Just assist. Somebody help me, please. Why are none of you doing anything? There we go. There we go. It's more like it. Alright, can we go home now, please? It definitely helps to give them sticks, and when we're going out and with the express purpose of actually killing things, we're definitely going out with sticks in the future. But, it's still a little touch and go whether they actually do anything. I do believe... I already saw this. Stop making me watch the horse get murdered. I do believe you can get your guys much better down the line at fighting and killing and stuff. It's just, it's going to take a little bit of practice. So the more we do it, though, the better we'll be. There we go. I'm just getting back. I'm done. I know everything's kicking off behind me. Wait, are you killing a horse? Did you just kill a horse? You just killed a horse. Look at him go. My apes are machines. Monkey Death Squad is definitely up for business. I love it. Unfortunately, we're about to drop down number of apes because I simply can't find... the ability to... Oh, right, yeah. You can't do this. You need to be an adult. I've lost an ape, unfortunately, which means we're going to go down to a 444 generation rather than a 666, but it's not the end of the world. Okay, it feels like the end of the world, but it's not the end of the world. What's going on? Hello, male. Lie down. Where's my... What the... When am I? What's going on? Is it because one of my apes is in trouble? There's a big red mark over here which tells me somebody's in a spot of bother. Although, where is it? It's over here somewhere. What's going on? Oh, it's been ravaged. Oh! I'm on my way, buddy. I've got your back. I don't know how to help you unless we can find a stick, however. What's that? Oh, I don't know what that is. Maybe that'll be a stick. Oh, that's the dead horse. Never mind. You carry on fighting. I'm just going to look at this horse for a minute. Alright. Are we good? The hyena is in the... Oh my god, no! Leave him alone! I'm on my way, buddy. I'm trying. Intimidate. Ooga booga. He's going into the base! The babies are in the base! Are we good now? One minor little addition at the end. I decided to skip forward another evolution just to move us around a little bit and hopefully, like I say, you know, get those extra two kids and go back up to a 666. We have become yet another species. I believe the penultimate species in the game is Ardipithecus ramidus, otherwise known as Ardi. Look at him there. The fur, especially around the chestal area, has gone back. The mouth and sort of like the jaw area is coming closer in, a bit more like a human as well. Pretty cool. We should see some new abilities pop in as well. Basically just a bare-chested hairy dude at this point in time. There's not a massive change between species if we're honest, but that's kind of what you'd expect. Evolution is a very gradual process, but we're different enough to warrant being called a new species. Learning how to make stick! Yes! We could already make stick, but now we can make good stick. And hopefully this will give us new... You remember last time we changed species, we got all these new abilities unlocking. Hopefully that's what we're going to see here as well with our new evolution. And hopefully a new base in the... Look at that, beautiful! God knows where we are, but I love it. It's nice, yeah! Wait, well, no. This looks like an old dude. It's a woman, but... Oopsie daisy. It's getting there, isn't it? It's becoming more human, very slowly. Where are we? Is the question. What's this place? Woodland, the Rocky Tarn Oasis. Right, it's a lovely area. I don't know where it is in relation to absolutely anything else, but it's a beautiful little spot now. So what we need to do, nice and quick, is find ourselves a sleeping spot. So we can check out what has happened evolutionary-wise. Do we have a sleeping... I'm sure we have a sleeping spot. I'm not crazy. I'm no longer sure we have a sleeping spot. All we're hoping for here, folks, is six babies and some cool new evolutionary traits, right? Those are the goals. Lots of areas over there we've not been to. What's that there, for example? That's a swamp. Hillock Oasis. Alright, cool. Right, we're going to make a bed. Only takes a second. So, hey, you know what, I was a little bit apprehensive about this video, felt like I hadn't really done much, but we got a brand new species, we saw hyenas and horses for the first time, we got even better at eating meat, great success, and then we went on a little journey to a brand new home. I'm going to call it success, I don't care if you guys do. Can we stack these, please? Silly ape. Come on, here we go, and make a bed. If there is one problem with this area, it's obviously quite difficult to block in. It's very, very open. But they all are at this point. The woodland is a very open area. Now, what did we get? So, Ardipithecus... Okay, more neuronal energy. Same as last time. That's pretty cool. We've also got life expectancy has increased. Even more stamina and energy. Nice big circle ball thing. We can get more dopamine. So we got all those last time as well. Is that from this? Full protection against food poisoning requires fewer items with curative properties. Also, orientation. We can remember yet more places, although I think I unlocked that one myself. Yeah. Less dopamine needed. There we go. How many generations? Only four. Damn it. It always keeps you the same number, annoyingly. Oh, right. That's a shame. I'm hoping motility, this area down here, is really where it's going to develop. We need this mutation. This one right here is the one we badly need, a genetic mutation. That's what I'm going to try to find. So my goal is basically, with our brand new species, we're going to go explore the woodland a little bit. I'm going to try to find another ape. We just need another female ape, and that way we can have the babies that we need. We can have the 6 babies and go back. She is terrifying, isn't she? She's absolutely goddamn terrifying. If we do that, we can have all the babies necessary and properly reinforced. Just checking. Yeah, she, adult female in a couple. I mean, you never know. Sometimes maybe they'll... Oh, that's an adult male. Maybe they'll give us her and she just won't have been bred yet, I guess is the term. Elder female, unfortunately. Adult male. Elder female. Where's all my hot young singles? You know? Never thought I'd say that about an ape, but here we are. Just babies everywhere. Everyone's very spread out. It worries me a little bit that we're all gonna get annihilated by Stalker Cat. Who are you over here? Like, you're a are you a baby? You're not a baby. You're an adult male, if I had to guess. What's wrong with you, buddy? Oh! Wait. Female? Breasts? Very promising. I think she's not part of the clan. I think she's just a random female. So what we need to do is cure her. If we can cure her, she will come and join the clan, and she'll be part of the clan with us, basically, right? That's what we're looking for. So, how do we cure what looks to be a broken arm? I think it's a broken bone, right? I was just going to get some kapok fiber for the ape up there, and I found yet another ape, who is... There you go. Not loving that, are you? What's up, buddy? Sick, right, that's sick. We need to give him some medicine or some description. I love this, though. Right, so I've had this problem all game where I couldn't find other apes. And it, but at the, this point, at least, it seems that the game is like, you know what, you've done well, right? You know, you deserve to be a happy little ape. I'm just going to chuck exactly what you need at your face. And they've provided. There's a male ape there and there's a female ape there. So we could, in theory, go back up to 6. Now, we don't actually have to bring in the male. All we need is one female. And that way, we'll be able to get the 6 babies that we need. The house is up here, by the way. I thought it was in quite a wide open area. And it's definitely not. It is way out of the way at the top of a massive cliff. There may be a better way up and down. Well, the best way down is to jump. There may be a quicker way up, but I haven't found it yet. For reference sake, that way down there is the dead zone, right there. So that right there is the jungle, where we came from, and then we walked down here. So we actually teleported from that side to this side. If you imagine the woodland, this big square, then if we go that way towards those question marks down there, that should be where the savannah is, I believe. Now, where's this young lass? Who's gonna give me some beautiful bibbers? Beautiful, delicious bibbers. Where's she at? I can hear her. She sounds sad. Sad? You're right, love. Right, is this gonna help you? God, I hope so. Nope, she's not having that either. Right, okay. I've clearly made a small mistake here. Maybe she has broken her arm. Okay, well, anyway, I will grab hold of one of those. We will skip for some generations, get some more mutations, blah, 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 blah. Explore the area, and then I think next video we're going to go try to take a look at this savannah. It's a really cool looking place. I know we haven't been in the woodland for very long, but I got the feeling the jungle is most of the game, and the woodland doesn't seem that big. But we'll go have a look. If I find anything cool, I'll definitely record it and bring it to you folks at home. Until then, 2.5 hours... ish after I started recording this bloody video. We're gonna end it there. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you lovely folks next episode. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.